Good morning. I also have a written statement that I can provide after this briefing. They'll also be going out electronically to your news media outlets. In the time since we located Selena's body on August 1st, we have gotten a number of press calls wanting to know the status of the investigation, and so this morning we're just here to give you sort of a briefing as to what we've been doing. At this juncture, at any given time, there always is at least a dozen police officers who remain active on this investigation. The FBI is still a critical partner in this investigation. Given the location of the residence to Vermont, we are still working closely with the Vermont authorities. We have to date received over 580 tips that have been reviewed and followed through. At this juncture, what we are asking is we are still asking the public for any help, anything that they may have seen or heard during July 25th, July 26th, or the days thereafter. We're asking for this information because, as we have told you previously, any piece of information could be the piece of the puzzle that we need to solve this tragedy of Selena's death. We are still treating this as a suspicious death. This remains an ongoing and active investigation, but at this point, no arrests have been made. The FBI previously indicated that there was a $25,000 reward for the location of Selena, as well as the arrest and prosecution of any individuals involved in her suspicious death. That is now being transferred. We are asking today that anybody with information about her death that leads to the arrest and prosecution, that $25,000 will be provided for that. In addition, there has been $5,000 placed in the Northway Bank. That, again, will be provided to anybody who provides information leading to the arrest and prosecution. We are asking the public if they want to donate, because we have had a number of calls for donations, that they can donate to that account, again, at the Northway Bank in Gorham. I have the phone number and the contact information that I will provide to you in writing. This investigation will remain active and ongoing. Our goal is that anybody that was involved in Selena's disappearance and ultimate death be brought to justice, but we are asking you and we are asking the public to help us with that.
What about the expansion of the timeline here, the 25th, 26th? Is there an indication that maybe she might have been missing earlier or something like
that? The beginning of that time frame goes to when she was last reported seen in her home, which was the night of Monday, the 25th. The information that we have that we've provided is that she was last seen approximately 9 o'clock in her house. As you are aware, she was reported missing on the 26th.
How many tips have actually generated some good leads for you guys? I mean, you've had all of these tips, but how close are you? I think what people want to know is there a child killer out there on the loose?
At this juncture, we are treating this as a suspicious death. We are doing everything we can to bring anybody involved into justice. So as we have indicated before, people are reminded to remain vigilant. And until arrest is made, we ask that they, are heightened in their vigilance.
Have you been able to identify persons of interest?
I'm not going to go into the specifics of, the individuals we have spoken to, but I can tell you that we have spoken to a number of different witnesses. We are exploring a number of forensic avenues in this case. As we have told you before, we have sent items out to Pennsylvania. We are in discussions with other agencies to determine if they could help us with some of the forensics in this case, as well as the state lab.
What about toxicology reports? What are you...
It's our hope that they are back within the next week or two.
Why is the toxicology so key?
The medical examiner has not ruled a manner and a cause of death. We are waiting for toxicology results to see if there was anything in Selena's system at the time of her death. So that is not the end-all piece, but it's certainly a piece in this puzzle, as is each piece of information. I have sort of described to some of you in my conversations with you that we are building a puzzle here, so we need the pieces to be put together to get the big picture, to make the determination what happened to her and determine if anybody should was anybody involved in that, and if they are, they will be held responsible.
Have you learned anything new about, you know, her whereabouts and her activities in the days before that might jar somebody's memory who otherwise not may not have paid attention?
The investigators in this case are doing a precise timeline as to her whereabouts, the days and the weeks and the months, as well as, you know, individuals that are associated with her. So we are trying to put those pieces together. But there may be pieces that we are missing because we were not in the house in the days before and after her disappearance. So that's why we're asking people who may have seen her, who may have seen other members of the family, to come forward with that information.
Are you surprised that it's taking the amount of time that it's taking you to find out?
Investigations of this nature sometimes take weeks and months. In order to build a criminal case, we have to have all the fundamental components, because if we ever get to a trial in this case, we want to ensure that we have enough evidence to reach a just result, which would be a finding of guilty if somebody is responsible and if somebody is charged. I'll take one more question from somebody who hasn't asked a question yet.
The $5,000 that's in the bank, is that the $5,000 provided by the anonymous donor mentioned early last month, or is this an addition?
That is correct. The anonymous donor initially had the information leading for whereabouts to the location of her body. Since we have asked for additional money, that anonymous donor has come forward again and said, you know, I will put this $5,000 forward, but it's tied now to the FBI criteria, which is arrest and prosecution of any individual or individuals responsible for her suspicious death. Thank you very much. I will have a handwritten press release for you to have that will have the name of the bank, the contact person of the bank, and the phone number.
Jane,
thank you very much.
People are very frustrated. Can you address that?